Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to part 4, airbrushing for beginners, troubleshooting. We're going to run through some brushes, point you out some little troubleshooting tips with the brands of brushes that I've got, that I've picked up along the years, and how you can get by these little hiccups that you're going to get. So we'll move on to the PS290. The little troubleshooting tips you can get with this brush. Now, it all goes down to how well you keep your brushes clean. That is the main thing, guys, when it comes to troubleshooting and things when your brush is not spraying correctly and things like that. It's if you leave paint in it overnight and it's dried up. A lot of the time, it's a dirty brush that causes you grief. Always, it's a dirty brush. So make sure your brush is really clean. Now, a little troubleshooting things with the PS290 is, that I've found is, you get two caps with the 290. You get the fan cap and you get the spot cap. It's very rare I use the spot cap. If you use the fan cap, that's where you'll get your little problems that you'll find. You have two little air holes on the sort of cap at the front. And when you've been spraying with the 290 for quite a while, you can get a buildup of paint on that cap. So I advise you to undo your thread at the front on your 290. Take your cap off and soak your prong cap and make sure the two little air holes are clean. If they're not clean, you'll see your fan pattern sort of go all weird. It'll be small, it won't be fully open. So that's the sort of thing that you're going to get with the 290. I've heard other people say about the actual nozzle inside that you unscrew. I've seen a video and someone had obviously wound it up too tight and snapped the thread. You don't need to take the nozzles off these brushes, you really don't. If you keep it flushed through after you've painted and cleaned it well, you'll have no problem. I've had this brush, it's got to be 3 years now, and I've had no dramas with the nozzle or from here down, none at all. I've had a sticky trigger where I've left a bit of paint in it before and the needle's sort of lodged in. If you get it where your needle, you've left a bit of paint in it by mistake and it is dried up, and you do that and you try and pull your needle out and it won't come out, I usually get undo the chuck at the back, pair of pliers, grip hold of the needle and just twist like that and then pull back, and it just releases that sticky bit of paint at the front. You just slide your needle out nice and easy. So yeah, 290, fan cap, that's the only bit you got to look out for. If you're using it regular, make sure it's clean. Right, we'll move on to Takumet or side feed, Micron side feed, any of the Iwata side feeds. Troubleshooting tips with these, it's very rare you sort of get any trigger wise or anything like that. If you get bad paint flow, again, it's dirty brush. Now, a little bit more fiddler, you can get a little bit of stubborn paint with these cups, because these are like two parts. You unscrew the bottom like that, you get a little gauze that sits in the bottom. So on these cups, you've got to clean through there, and then you get a little pipe cleaner and clean through there and just blow through. Just make sure when you blow through, you can feel the air blowing through on the cups. That can be a little bit of a bugbear with these, and on the bits where you clip your side cup, you can get buildup of paint through there. So just make sure that's nice and clean through that way, and your cup is nice and clean through the side bit there that clips into the brush and the bit underneath that you unscrew. They're the little troubles you can get with them. H&S's, troubleshooting with the H&S. I'm going to run through some other troubleshooting with these as well. Very rare. I really like H&S brushes because they're just the easiest brush to put back together. Troubleshooting with these, if you sometimes get, when you've got an old H&S on the floating nozzles at the front where you slide your nozzle out, you get the little Teflon washer on the front. After a while, them Teflon washers compress where they're, when you put them back in to the brush and you screw on your air cap, after years of use, that little Teflon washer can go a little bit flat. so you don't get a really good seal when you close this up. You don't really get a good seal to the main body inside. Best advice, buy a pack of Teflon washers. They're dirt cheap. Put a new Teflon washer on, and then when you tighten up, you're good to go. If you get another seal problem on the H&S at the front, it will be, same thing again, it will be, you take your floating nozzle out, and it's where your prong cap, your air cap piece is there. You have a little rubber washer that sits around that thread there. If you've been using solvents or you've been wiping your brush down with solvents, that little rubber washer can get perished, and they sort of like change shape, and you don't get a real good seal to the front. They're the only two bits on the H&S. It's very rare, and it's over years of use with the Teflon washers. And it's very rare the rubber one goes, but if they do go and you're getting problems at the front where it's sort of like bubbling back when you press down and you can spray and you're getting bubbles coming back up, it's the seal to the front end. And that goes across the board for the Micron, the Takuma, it can be the seal to the front end. When it comes to spraying, and if you're spraying, another little troubleshooting tip, and you're going up and say something really fine and detailed with your brush, and you're going to do a dot, and when you spray your dot, it looks sort of skew whiff to the paper, or it looks like a little tiny little line instead of a dot. A lot of the times that can be on the front of your brush there, where you've got the needle that sticks out the end, that bit there where the needle comes out, you can have a buildup of paint on that. It's really common to get, when you get tip dry, we all pinch the needle and clean the tip dry, but you get a little bit of buildup on that air cap piece at the front, right where the needle comes out, and you've got the hole, you can get a buildup of paint there. So just make sure you give that a little wipe around there and clean the paint off. If it's still doing that, just check your needle, because you can have a bent needle as well, and that can be throwing your spray pattern off. You can get needle straighteners and things, but my advice, take the needle out. Needles aren't that expensive. Buy a new needle and put a new needle straight in your brush, and it will stop the issues of like spray patterns being off. You can see your spray pattern as well. If you get some black cardboard, hold some cardboard up, put some water in your brush, and you'll know if your needle dinked at the end. Spray and look at the spray pattern. If it's dinked, it'll throw the spray pattern off. It won't be a nice cone coming out. It'll slightly send it off sort of to the side or up or down. So you'll notice that. So that's another little troubleshooting tip. Another one is as well, you've been painting, you're leaving your airbrush in your hanger and it's been sitting like that for a day and paint ran down. And then when you pick your airbrush up, you're pressing down on your trigger and your trigger just goes flat to the bottom. The air keeps coming out and the trigger won't come up. It's stuck. Now, it's not actually the actual trigger. It's the air valve here. When you dismantle your brush and take your trigger out, you've got a little pin. When you look down inside that gap where the trigger is, there's a little pin that does this. So where your air goes in here, when you press down on the trigger, it pushes the little valve down and then releases the air out. What that's doing is, where paint's gone in to the brush at the back here, it's a bit of paint's gone around that pin that moves up and down, and it just makes it stick. So when you press the trigger down, it just sticks, and all you're getting is air, just permanent air. And when you take it off, it takes ages to come back to the top. So take your trigger out, cotton bud, mild airbrush cleaner. Don't put thinners down this bit, guys, because thinners will destroy that piece of that valve in there. It's a real mild, either soapy water will do it. Bit on a cotton bud and then put it down inside the brush and just work it around that pin with the trigger out. And that will release that valve and it will stop your sticky trigger. So that's another little troubleshooting tip. Another one as well is, when you go to paint, we've all done this, I've done it, and you go to paint, or you've been painting for quite a while, and you press down, you're going up to your work, and your paint is instantly coming out, and you're not pressing back, but you press down, and you've got paint, very minimal bit of paint coming out. What that can be is when you've been airbrushing for quite some time, you can get a build up on your needle and it starts to just push your needle back slightly and it doesn't locate to the front of the nozzle. So your best thing to do is undo the chuck at the back. I'd remove your needle, give your needle a clean down, slide your needle back in, relocate it to the front and just tighten the chuck up. Because most of the time it's sometimes where the chuck's loose and your needle's slightly just not centering and locating to the nozzle at the front, and that's just letting paint come straight out. Your needle's not closing off to the nozzle sort of like that. Closing off, it's sitting slightly back and it's letting paint flow. So that's another one, little troubleshooting you can find and you'll see. So that's sort of covered troubleshooting tips. It's very rare you get other things sort of happen. You can get, I've not had it on any of my Iwatas, my Krios, the Rich Pen, where you will be pressing and you'll see little bubbles coming out here, round here. The only brush that tends to have a little bit of air leak for me round here is the Sotar, and they're renowned for it. But the Iwatas, the Krios, every other brushes have been absolutely fine. If you get a little bit of air leakage here, and the best way to test it is get a little bit of soapy water, rub it around the front of your brush there so it's wet. You can even use a bit of spit off your fingers, wipe it around the front of the brush, press on the air, and then when you start to sort of pull back, you'll see bubbles coming up around the front of the brush here. Now what that is this seal just here. So where you've got your brush and you've got your air cap, it's the seal here. Now the way around that, to get around that, is you can get like the beeswax. I think Iwata's just released one. You put a little smear of that on and then you just screw your air cap back on, nip it up, and then that will stop any leakages there. It's very rare, if you do get a little bit of leakage out of that, it won't stop your airbrushing. Your airbrush will still perform, but you'll just probably hear a little leak here. Sometimes you get leaks here as well. Another little troubleshooting tip is on some of these quick connects, on the cheaper ones, like the ones on Amazon, they're made in China, the bulk loads, inside there you get a little rubber washer that sits inside that quick connect. Sometimes when you tighten these up to it, and it's done it on this brush now, you can see the black rubber that's pushed into the bottom of the airbrush, that little black washer there. Sometimes you get that and that pushes into the valve and it won't push air through. So just be careful on that, on your quick connects, that your washer inside the quick connect hasn't come out the bottom of the body of this and gone up and got stuck into the bottom of your brush like that, how I've just shown you now. So just put that on. If you're getting a little bit of leakage, because I guarantee the cheaper ones do leak, they really do, and the quick connects, they do leak as well, get a little bit of PTFE tape, wrap it around the thread, and then just nip this up, and that will stop your leaks there. Some of the quick connects that you put on, I've got one up there where you clip it on, you're airbrushing, and then when you're sort of working, you can feel, you can knock your hose and you can hear air coming out, because some of the seals on the cheaper ones of these, they work, but you just get a little bit of movement like that left and right and you'll hear air releasing. It's just on the cheaper ones of these that you'll get it. Some of the expensive ones, H&S ones, Iwata ones, they'll be a lot better, guys. But if you've opted for the cheaper ones, it won't affect your airbrush if you're hearing air slightly coming out of this, because this one does it. I'll be painting, catch that, and then it goes sort of loose. Another little troubleshooting tip is these ones you get with the Mac valves, go for a branded one. Sparmax do one, Iwata do one, H&S do one. Spend a little bit more money on the quick connect that's got the regulator to the side, because they're better. The cheap Chinese ones that have got the little adjuster here, I guarantee it, drop your comments, because I've had it happen to me. When you dial these in, yes, they work, but sometimes you'll see that pin fly across your studio and then all of a sudden you get an almighty blast of air because the pin that you regulate on is just shot out because there's no sort of stop start on it. It sort of like unwinds itself and just pings across the studio. I've got one up there that does it and it scares the living out of you when it pings out and you've got air pressure coming out, especially when you're on detailed work. So just watch out for the ones with the cheaper ones with the regulators. Go for a branded one, they're much better. I'll leave a link in the description to everything Airbrush they cover. You can buy the cheap ones from there and you can buy the branded ones as well. So I think that's covered troubleshooting tips. Yeah, I will see you in the next one. Don't forget, if you're new to the channel, click that subscribe, press that notification, and I will see you in part 5.